Sahlan, ya Marhaba. Inshallah, we're going to take you for an exclusive tour of the University of Medina.
This footage is brought to you exclusively by Roadside Islam.
So how was your journey, Ak?
Alhamdulillah, I'm just going to go around, see where the students are knowledge, where they do it at.
Inshallah.
These buildings over here are some of the buildings where the tullab, the students, are living. And even this one on your right hand side. Each building has about maybe 5 floors, and on every floor, I don't know how many students there are. But over here, you've got the place where you can wash your clothes, just over there. You can get it washed, get it ironed. Further down, you can.
Maghsil.
Rasta.
So do you have to share rooms?
Yeah. In each room, depending on which building that you're in, the older the building, the more people to a room. The newer the building, the least amount of people to a room.
Right, why is that?
It's the way they set it up. The older building, 6 people to a room. Imagine that. In one room, big room, 6 people in that room. Yeah. The newer building, so we're going to see with Abdul Hakim, there's only 2 people.
So how do you find that? Do you find it hard? Because obviously people from different countries, they've got different cultures and different habits.
Yeah.
So do you find it difficult to deal with? Or
definitely, man. With problems with regards to the air conditioner.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes somebody might want the air conditioning on, you might want it off. And it can become problematic. But if you've got good roommates, alhamdulillah, you're okay.
Alhamdulillah.
Let's walk. Okay. This is one of the mat'ams, the restaurants that you can eat in. This one you have to pay money for. The other mat'ams down there, the students can eat there for free.
Oh, so sure,
like, no. So this is like a restaurant you have to pay to eat in this one, and the other one up there is free.
No, same
thing. Sure,
so what's the different levels of food like?
I like this place, man. You can get chicken rice, you can get shawarma, you can get chicken and chips.
It varies, isn't it? What you pay for, what you get is what you pay for.
So what's the free food, what's that like?
It's not free. At the beginning when you come it's free because you're a new student,
yeah.
they give you vouchers, you're able to eat for free, but when you come here now, obviously now the prices vary, but you also see the varieties of food, they also vary as well. So it's a bit, the quality is a bit more better. Well, basically this is the Imada here, so if like a new student comes, this is where he would have to come to get all his paperwork filled in. You know, like his registration, and he comes to get his student card, and any of the affairs that needs to be sorted out for the new students, they need to come here.
Do you find it quite efficient when you came?
Alhamdulillah, because there were other brothers that preceded us in the journey. Alhamdulillah, it was a bit easy, but.
Did you have any difficulties?
No doubt there's difficulties, but alhamdulillah, you know. Like with everything that you do here, the difficulties are gonna come from it. But alhamdulillah, this is Kulliyat al-Sharia, the faculty of Sharia. So once a person, like for instance, a foreign student, he comes from the West and he's unable to speak Arabic, and he completes his first two years in the Ma'ad al-Ta'lim al-Lugha, that is basically. Institute for the learning of the Arabic language. After he completes his first 2 years, then he will move on to whichever faculty that he's interested in, whether it be Kulliyat al-Sharia, Kulliyat al-Da'wah, Kulliyat al-Hadith, Kulliyat al-Quran al-Kareem. There are many Kulliyat that a person can choose from, you know, once completing his 2 years in the Institute of Arabic.
So you have to complete basically 2 years, and then you come off to this side, and then you pick like what direction you like.
Basically, when you finish with your 2 years, then you can choose whichever one of the kulliyat that you want to go into. And this is alhamdulillah, this is like one of the most popular in the kulliyat.
But it don't have to be 2 years in the ma'had. You might go and they might say, okay, your Arabic strong enough to go into Mustawa Thalith. You might only have to complete 1 year.
What's that?
Level number 3. Okay. You have these 4 levels: level 1, 2, 3, and 4. Alhamdulillah, the masjid's over there.
So what is that? That's the masjid for all the students?
Yeah, basically this is the masjid for the Jamia, and most of the students.
How many masjids there? Just one?
This is the main masjid. There are other little like for instance, Kulliyat al-Sharia, they have a musalla masjid in there. But this is the actual masjid for the Jamia.
So when there's Jumu'ah,
when it's Yawm al-Jumu'ah, the Salah, the khutbah is given here. Okay, now
we're at the Ma'had for Ta'lim al-Lughat al-Arabiya. This is where the new students that need to go through the Arabic language process go to study from 7:30 in the morning to 12:30. MashaAllah.
Now, this is Kulliyat al-Hadith al-Sharif, where they specialize in Hadith and sciences of Hadith.
As you're done.
As long as you can hear this, the adhan for Salat al-Maghrib.
The building Al-Wahda Al-Thani. This is the building that I'm staying in. When I first came to the Jamia, they put me in Al-Wahda Al-Ula, which is right here. And in Al-Wahda Al-Ula, the first building, there's six people to a room. Okay, so you're in a room with five other people, and there's no partition. So what I tried to do was I went to this imada here, and I tried to, you know, complain and say, listen, I can't have six people to a room. I've got valuables with me. And they said, listen, go to all the other buildings here, and if you can find a spare room, we'll give it to you, no problem. So alhamdulillah, after about 3 or 4 days, I managed to find a room in Al-Wahda Al-Thani, where we're going now. And that's a bit better. There's 4 people to a room, and each person's section is partitioned off, mashallah. So I've got my own little section, and I'm going to take you there now, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is the building, Al-Wahda Al-Thani, the second building. And this is the room I was telling you about. This room here has 4 people to a room. And as you can see, all of the rooms are partitioned off. This is one room here. This is another room here. And another section. Another section here. And another section here. MashaAllah. You know, it's got the potential to be very cozy. But, tafadhal. Bismillah. Ahlan wa sahlan. This is my quarters right here, mashallah, tabarakallah. I've got a nice little setup. I've got my bed, I've got my desk, my computer, mashallah, a few books that a few brothers helped me get the other day. And I've got my internet as well. So, mashallah, it's got the potential to be very comfortable. You know, chat to my family, surf the net if I need to surf the net for anything. And then I've got my clothes, everything that I need here, mashallah. You know, and if you've got good roommates in your room, then it makes the whole experience of being in a room with 4 other people that much more easier and enjoyable, mashallah.
So right now, how many people are you sharing with?
4 people. Sorry, okay. 3 people. 4 including myself. It's 4 together.
Okay.
Right now, we're just leaving the older apartments, mashallah, and we're going to make our way over to Hollywood. Look over there, so where the newer buildings are placed. And in the newer buildings, there at least there
the rooms, basically the rooms, it consists of.
Does
it all
want a drink?
Yeah.
No, I'll get me a drink back. Go on, you get me a drink. Carry on that.
Basically, the rooms in the new building, they consist of 2 people to a room. So it will be you. Like for instance, me, I live in this new building here. It's called Thani Ata Ashar. I live in there with 1 more person, another brother. So alhamdulillah, you know, it's much more cleaner than the older, and obviously it's newer than the older building as well. Alhamdulillah, we take the chicken up here now. Assalamu alaikum, ahlan wa sahlan. This is my room. Alhamdulillah, I'm in the new building where there's 2 people that share to a room. I like the other buildings, some of the older buildings. There's only 2 people. Alhamdulillah. This is my side here. This is my table. And I've got my laptop. So if I need to talk to family or anything like that, it's, you know, it's easy for me. These are my books and whatnot. These are some of the books that I'm studying in the Ma'had, the Ilm al-Lugha. You know, so most of the time, this is where I would do revision and most of the stuff. You know, alhamdulillah. So you got your wardrobe there. The AC and the left. this side here, this is the brother that I live in, this is his side. Alhamdulillah, this is the kitchen. On their day to day, when they finish their studies, they can come and they cook their lunch, dinner, whatever they want to call it, whatever it is. This is where it goes down. Basically, this is the washroom. So everyone, everyone has, each has their own washing machine, and then everyone just does their thing in there, clean your clothes in there. Buses. After every Salat al-Asr, they take the Tuwab to the Haram, the Masjid al-Nabawi. And then after Isha, they pick us up again and they bring us back to the Jam. And this is on a daily basis.
Why? Why do they do this every day?
It's just a form of transport for the students, isn't it? And it's free as well, so alhamdulillah,
So Aki, what's the procedures of how the people have to enroll in the university and what?
Basically, from what I done, I came here for Ramadan, and basically you have to have an application form, so you fill in the application. It's better that it's done in Arabic, so if you're unable to speak Arabic, you get someone that will be able to help you with that, and then you fill in that, and then you have to have two letters of recommendation from like Islamic Society or anything, or from your local masjid, two letters, or and another masjid. Basically, it's a letter of recommendation, just with a brief about who you are and whatnot. And to say that, we know this person and, mashallah, we give him recommendation to say that, he's a good student and whatnot. And you also need to have around 10 pictures or something like that, 10 photos. What else? Just have like your birth certificate. And also you have to have a qualification that has been done within like the last 5 years. So whether it be GCSEs or whether it be like some college certificate or something, just to show that this person is indulged in he's been involved in education like within the last 5 years. So that's most of the things that you need. And then any other little qualifications, any like little certificates, just to say maybe you've done like a short course, maybe in Arabic or any kind of Islamic studies in your masjid, something like this. All of that kind of stuff is good, as well.
So what about if you ain't got GCSEs and stuff, you can still get in, or does it
make it up? You can still get in. You can still get in. Without that, you can still get in. But maybe you might have to go through the secondary school, it's called Thaniyah. So maybe you might have to go through that. And that can be anything to like 1 year to 3 years, the duration of that. But you can still get in. It's not just bam, you haven't got the qualification, so that's khalas, you can't come.
So how do you find out when you admitted into the uni?
Basically, who comes out, you might find out around May to June time. Some students or like some other people, they might post something on the internet to basically say, we've got the name, these are the names for the accepted students for this year for the Islamic University of Medina and so forth.
So students post it on the internet?
Yeah, people, as soon as they find out, that's how I found out.
So the uni don't directly contact you?
They send the acceptance letter to your house. But before that, the names they come up on the list. The names they come up on the list that someone posted on the internet. Like when I heard that I got in, it was a brother that called me and said, mashallah, you got into the jam. To try and apply. When you get here, you come to this building here, Imada, you come in here, and then basically you'll have the interview, you'll be assessed by one of the people that work there. It's better if you know someone that they're able to translate for you. Or if you don't know anyone, inshallah, you can come here and meet some of the students, someone that's able to speak English, and then they'll come, they'll be able to assist you with that. So you come here, you'll be assessed by one of the people that work here, and they'll ask you minor questions, they might ask you to recite some Quran. They might ask you a few questions, maybe what is shirk, and just minor questions. It's not really an assessment to say whether this person is going to be accepted or not. It's just basic, it's just general, you know.
What are they trying to see, roughly, like, what kind of direction you're coming from?
Where you're coming from, you know, what kind of understanding you have. But it doesn't actually determine whether to say that, yeah, this person, he gets in or not. But it's just, like, it's general, basically.
So after the assessment, what happens then?
After that assessment, class, that's it. So what you do now, depending on when, you basically have to wait for a year now.
A year afterwards, yeah, even after you've been accepted?
Depending on when you applied, then you have to wait for a year, for the previous year now, to say, okay, when this year starts now, then you'll see whether your name has come up.
Yeah.
So if your name has come up as one of the accepted students, then there's another procedure that you have to go through from then.
And what's that procedure?
Basically, it's a year that you have to know, you have to wait, and you'll know whether you are accepted or not.
Okay, just a pull up.
This court here is where the students of the Jamiat al-Islamiyya, they can come and play football, basketball. Even if you come closer, you can see straight down there they've got like a bar. You see some of the students on like a Thursday night, Friday night, they start doing some workouts, pull-ups, chin-ups and stuff like that. This place is generally open all the time, but you find that Thursday night, Friday night is where it's packed out. All this area here, where you can see the gravel, you see some of the brothers from all different countries playing football. You might have, you know, a basketball match playing, also a football match. You see these people, the chairs around the side of the court, people playing, just spectating. So it's a very, very, very nice vibe, you know. We've also got a gym, which is outside of campus, and inshallah ta'ala, I'll take you there later on.
So bro, so when on Thursday nights, so all the brothers are mixing together?
Everyone's mixing together. People from different cultures, people from different countries, all coming together, speaking one language, mashallah, which is the Arabic. And it's fun. It's fun. It's a nice way, after that hectic week studying Arabic and whatever kulia you're in, just to, you know, release and just, you know, let your hair down.
Alhamdulillah, the day in the life of a talib in the Jamia, student in the University of Islamiyya. Basically, Fajr comes in now about 5 o'clock, quarter past 5. So your day really starts from there. 5 o'clock in the morning, you get up, you know, you perform your wudu, and you head down to the masjid, which is just over there, mashallah. After you've prayed the salah and jama'at, many students, they stay in the masjid until the rise of the sun, and they spend their time with different types of ibadat, you know, reading Quran, maybe studying Arabic, doing some memorization. And then after that, wait for the sun to rise, approximately 10-15 minutes after that, and then they pray the 2 rakats to obtain the rewards of, you know, doing Hajj or Umrah with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. After that, if you have a mut'am ticket, a restaurant ticket, you can make your way, this is about maybe 6 o'clock now, make your way to the mut'am and eat your breakfast. You know, you might spend half an hour in the mut'am eating. After that, it's about 6:30, go back to your room, go and have a shower, get ready for the day's work. Darasa starts, studies start at 7:30 in the morning. So by the time you get to lesson, you've eaten, you know, you've already, you're not half asleep, you're already awake because you've been up since Fajr. And then, you know, you start the lesson, mashallah. It's from 7:30 to 12:30. Once you finish Darasa, you know, you're going to be quite tired. You might, the Darasa stops at the Adhan of Salat al-Dhuhr. After Salat al-Dhuhr, after you've prayed in the masjid, then you can either go back to your room, catch up on some sleep from Dhuhr to Asr, or you can just stay in your room or do whatever you want. Generally, what the students recommend that you do is between Dhuhr and Asr, which is the hottest time of the day, you get a sleep, because you need the rest for later on, whether you want to go to the gym, whether you want to study, or do whatever. Salat al-Asr, now this is your time to revise the notes that you've taken earlier that day, or to do anything you want. When I came to the Jamia, all of the brothers were advising me, you know, get a schedule, get a schedule, get a schedule. It's imperative for your development in the Jamia. So if you were somebody that did want to make a schedule, after Asr would be a good time, up until Salat al-Isha, to concentrate on Quran. If you're in the Ma'had, going over your notes for the Arabic language. And that, in a nutshell, is the day in the life of a talib, over and over and over again, you know. Some brothers, they choose after Salat al-Isha, which is about 7:30, they go to the gym and just, you know, have a little workout just to cool off and relax. Alhamdulillah.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Amma ba'd. My name is Ismail Muhammad Noor. I'm Somali originally, and I grew up in Sweden. I've been studying in the Jami'ah for about 3-4 years now, alhamdulillah, and since the beginning, the very beginning, I've been benefiting. And what comes to mind is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, "ما يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين." Whoever Allah wants khair for, He makes him comprehend the religion. And the ulama, the scholars, they've also said that bilaks, the contrary is true too. That if Allah does not want good for a person, then He makes him not understand the religion. So by coming to Medina, the Prophet city, there's very good chance for a person to learn Islamic in an authentic way, taken from the scholars and from the hadith of the Prophet.
I'm your brother Tariq Muhammad Hassan. I'm from Holland, and I'm studying now for the third year in Kulliyat al-Hadith. And I'd just like to tell you that it's a big ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are studying here in this this university, Islamic University in Medina. And we have learned very much, alhamdulillah. We've learned very much of the Lugha al-Arabiya, the Arabic language. We've memorized much of the Quran, alhamdulillah. We all have benefited very much from the Jami Islamiyah. So we hope that also the other people and brothers, inshallah, will come of other countries, so that they also will benefit of this beautiful Jami. And also the teachers, we have learned from them very much things, the good akhlaq, and do our best in school and things like that, and have very high,
standards.
I hope that the brothers, inshallah, also in the other countries do their best to come here, that they're studying, so that they will go back and they will learn the people and the meaning of La ilaha illallah, and and that's important.
Salamu ala Rasulillah. My name is Abdul Rafi, and I'm from Baltimore, Maryland, which is in the United States of America. I'm a student here at the Jamia, Jamia Islamiyah, which is in Medina. I'm a second-year student in the Mahad, and after this year, inshallah, if Allah wills, I will enter into the one of the colleges, inshallah. In regards to my my time here, I would no doubt say that it is a very beneficial environment. I've benefited tremendously. I literally came here with no Arabic background or Islamic studies, and alhamdulillah, with the blessing of Allah, I've excelled tremendously. The environment is a very good Islamic environment. The studies are very good. The programs, the lessons, and the teachers are also very good. And in general, I would say this is a very good environment to study if one intends to study. Well, I would firstly advise the people to have a good intention and to be patient, because it's a new environment. It's different as opposed to us foreigners coming from the West. So one should exercise a lot of patience, a lot of diligence, and focus.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. My name is Hanif. I come from Cardiff. I'm a student in Jamia al-Islamiyya. This is my second year in the Arabic Institute. And, alhamdulillah, since I've come here, I've learned a lot of Arabic. I met a lot of good brothers from all over the world. And, alhamdulillah, it's a big ni'mah to be here. You know, in regards to the environment, and, you can pray in the Masjid al-Nabawi, you can benefit from the ulama. So, I mean, alhamdulillah, it's a big ni'mah from Allah Azza wa Jal. So, all your brothers out there, you should apply and do your best to come to the Jamia, inshallah. I mean, this year, only 3 out of 10 brothers came from UK. So, I mean, if you have the desire to come here, and you have the means, and apply inshallah, and Allah make it easy for all of us.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Salim, I'm from America. Basically, the Jamia has done wonders for me. I've been here maybe, this is about going on a year and a half now, and I've learned maybe 20 times what I've benefited, maybe 20 times from what I've known now and from what I knew then. The Prophet ﷺ, he says, "May yuridillahi bihi khayran yufakkihu fi din." Whoever Allah wants good for, He gives him an understanding of religion. And wallahi, the Jamia is one of the best places for you to get and gain an understanding of your religion. The flip side of that is that whoever Allah doesn't want good for, He doesn't give them understanding of religion. So trying to gain understanding of religion and go to places like Damaj or Kuwait is some of the best places for learning religion. But I think the Jamia is tops among that list. So inshallah, you see this and you apply it.
I hope you've enjoyed the tour of the Islamic University of Medina. Inshallah, for those that are interested in seeking knowledge, bismillah, this will be a good place for you to start, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.